Hello friends, I'm Naishik from blog2.com and welcome to another amazing video. In this video, I'll give you some tips and tricks about how you can select the best and the perfect domain name for your website business. Now, a domain name is a very important part of your business because that is the thing that is going to stick with you for a very long time, okay? That is the name that people will remember your website, remember your brand, remember your website whenever they want to come to your website, whenever they want to visit your website. That is the name that they have to type in the URL bar to come to your website. So that name has to be unique. That has to be a short name, that has to be a name that anyone and everyone can remember. So I have selected a list of 10 different tips that will really help you to select the perfect domain name for your website business. Now before starting this video, make sure you guys subscribe to my channel and also click on that bell icon so that you don't miss any future videos. With that being said, let's get started. Now the first thing or the first tip is selecting the perfect domain extension. Now there are so many different extensions available in the market. Some of the really popular ones include .com, .net, .org, .co, .biz, and there are many bizarre domain names like .rock, .professor, .lawyer, .xyz and so on and so forth. Okay, now although there are many different domain names available, you should always go with the .com extension, and there are two major reasons for that. The first one is that people are more familiar with .com domains than with anything else. They will default to typing .com into the browser address bar and are unlikely to remember your extension if it's too weird. Everyone will always assume a website is a .com. Okay, so very important. The second reason is the .com extension is used by 3/4 of all websites. So if you can't get the .com, go with other well-known extensions like .co or .net or .org. Now they are different. For example, if you're creating a website for an organization, then .org will be better than the .com one. Okay, but if you're creating a website for a business, for a e-commerce and so on, there is another thing that suppose you're creating a website for a specific country like for India, then you can select the country specific thing like .in, .in and so .in. Or if you're creating a website targeting only one particular country like UK, you can select your website name .uk. Okay, so in these cases you can select .org or country specific domain like .in or something like that. But for most of you guys, for most of the website, I would recommend you to select the .com one. That is the most common one, most popular one, and people really default to type that extension at the end of any website. Okay, so this was the first tip, that we have to select the perfect domain extension, and I recommend selecting .com. Now let's move on to the second one. The second tip is to choose a brandable name. Okay, we all know that branding is crucial in a long-term success, but what exactly makes a domain name brandable? Now that is a million-dollar question. There are many factors that come into play here, but the most important ones are as follows. First, a brandable name has no specific meaning. Example, Google. Google doesn't have any meaning. YouTube, it does not have a meaning either. Okay, so a brand name does not need to have a meaning. Okay, it should not have a specific meaning. The second one is that it should be unique. Your competitors should not use anything similar. Okay, or you should not use any similar domain name like your competitor is using. Very important. The third one is that it should be easy to memorize, not too wordy, not complex vowel combinations. Okay, simple word like Google, very simple and easy to remember, easy to pronounce, very easy. Okay, so it should be easy to memorize, and also it should be easy to pronounce and dictate over the phone. Okay, so this is also a very important point that many experts say that this should be very important point. Like someone asks you about your domain name and you are on a phone, then you can say, okay, it's google.com, it's nayer.com. It should not be a complicated or a lengthy word that should that should confuse the person on the other side. Also, it should sound trustworthy. Now some names can be a little shady by definition. For example, winthelotterytoday.com may be too bold, but loterio.com sounds way better. Okay, so to make this process a little easier, you can experiment with some combination of actual actual words and run random suffixes like we have seen in the above examples in our Letteria.com. Okay, so I hope these tips help you. Okay, so this was the second one, to choose a brandable name. Now the third tip is to avoid hyphens, numbers and double letters. Very important again. Now I have seen many people keeping website like Nayer-shake.com, Nayer_shake.com. okay, these kind of website. Now don't do this mistakes, okay, because numbers and hyphens are often misunderstood. People who hear your website address doesn't know if you're using a numeral 5 or if it's spelled out 5, like F-I-V-E 5. Okay, also never create a domain name with hyphens. Hyphens can be a sign of spam domains, which you do not want to be associated with. You don't want to give the wrong impression to potential visitors. Hyphenated domains are also prone to typos. If you choose a domain name with hyphens because the domain name you want is already taken, your users will end up to your competitor's site if they forget to type in the hyphens. Okay, so very bad idea to use any hyphen numbers or double letters. Now double letters, also avoid that because it increases your chances of losing traffic to typos. Okay, for example, if you're creating a website domain like WordPress setup. Now WordPress already has double S and the setup has S at the beginning. So if you're creating a website and the domain name is wordpresssetup.com, which has three consecutive S, it will be more prone to typos and result in loss of traffic. Okay, so avoid these things. So this was our third tip. Let's move on, and the fourth tip is to keep it short, simple and predictable. Now make sure your domain name is short. Try to keep it under 10 to 15 characters. Don't ever exceed, or try to not exceed the 15 characters, because that would be really long one. Okay, also keep your domain name simple, which means avoid hyphens, underscores or any complicated word as part of the domain. Now we talking about predictable, make sure you don't use any weird spellings. For example, we can see an example over here. Suppose if your name is Mike with Y, okay, M-Y-K-E, Mike, and you want to make it a part of your domain, such as Mike Blogs, MikeWebsite.com, then every single time people will mistype it as M-I-K, MikeBlogs.com, okay? So avoid these things. Now this brings us to our fifth suggestion, or our fifth point, or our fifth tip, that we have to, if you're creating something like this, buy the other extensions and common misspellings of your domain. Like we have seen in the previous example, if you want to create, or if you want to include your name, and if your name is M-Y-K-E, then also buy the M-I-K-E version. Okay, so Mike Blogs and Mike Blogs with I. Okay, so make sure to do so. Okay, now that will obviously increase some expenses, but you know, if your budget is that much, you can do so. And also you can buy some other extensions, like my website name is blogdude.com. Now I can buy blogdude.in as well, okay, if I fear that someone will use this for wrong purposes. And if I have the capacity and money, it is a very good idea to buy some other extensions as well, because you know, if you go in the market, if you go to some website and search for Google and you search any domain extension like .com, .rock, .io, .whatever, that thing will not be available. Now obviously it's a big brand and you cannot get a brand domain name, but at the same time they acquire all the extensions. Okay, so if you can do so, get as many extensions as possible with the same name, okay, and with some misspellings, like blogdude.com can be blogdude.com or blogg, you know, like that. So if possible, do that. Now the sixth tip is to make it pronounceable, and we have seen this example previously, that we have to make a website that is easy to pronounce over phone, you know, very important. We don't want to keep some really tough word, including so many vowels that, you know, whenever we pronounce it to someone, they would be like, what, can you please repeat, what was that name, I don't remember that name, that is not at all easy to remember. Okay, so please make sure that your domain name is pronounceable, it's easy, short, simple. Okay, so this was our sixth tip. Now let's move on to the seventh tip, that we have to use keywords very sensibly. Now it's true that having some keywords in your domain name can help. However, you shouldn't bend over backwards to include exact match phrases. Doing so can actually hurt your brand. Google caught on this spammy tactic, so an exact match keyword domain isn't much of a ranking factor anymore. Besides, many users have developed the impression that such sites are spammy and low quality. Which men's athletic, now let me ask you one thing. Which men's athletic shoe domain do you think sounds more professional and trustworthy? The first one being sportsdirect.com and the second one buymenssportsshoes.com. Okay, so obviously it's the first one. Now, I would like to give you a simple advice. You know, avoid using generic keywords and phrases exclusively. Not only are they hard to remember, but domain names based solely on generic keyword strings don't carry the same SEO benefits that they used to. The next step is to use a dictionary or a thesaurus for domain name ideas. Fine, now let me tell you one thing very clearly. No matter what I say about picking a domain name that's brandable, simple, has a good ring to it, it's easy to remember, and so on and so forth. The fact of the matter is that coming up with a truly good name is really, really difficult. Sometimes you'll easily go through tens of different terms before you settle on the perfect one, while other times nothing will seem good enough. In that case, thesaurus.com or vocabulary.com or websites similar to this like dictionary.com can be a secret weapon in your arsenal. These sites will help you find synonyms and also provide quick definition to help you not make a silly mistake by building your domain name around a word with a meaning you have misunderstood. Okay? Now, you should note one thing that we have already seen this in the previous example, that try to use some different suffixes, use a regular random word and some different suffixes, like for lottery example, we have seen loterio.com, something like that, okay? So that you get a different product name, a unique name and a brandable name, okay? Very, very important. Use the word, search the word in the dictionary, in thesaurus, whatever you find is good, and use some different suffix to make it unique. Now, moving on to our next tip, you know, you can help yourself to some domain name generators. This is another kind of helper that you can use if you're finding it hard to come up with a cool domain name and thus, by extension, your business name as well. These tools are very simple to use and also surprisingly helpful. All they need is one keyword from you. Now let me show you some examples. There are three different websites that I recommend. The first one is Lean Domain Search, the second one is Domain Name Generator, and the third one is Nameboy. Okay, use these tools. You can type in just one keyword and you'll get many different suggestions. For example, if you type in coffee, you will get like coffee day, coffee shop, something like that. Okay, some prefix, some suffix, and those kind of things will be included, and you'll get many different ideas. I think, you know, it will be very, very easy for you. Even if you don't like those things, you will at least get an idea, and you know that will expand your mind and you can select something better from your choice. Okay, so use these things. I'll try to give these links in the video description below. Again, let me repeat these websites: Lean Domain Search, Business Name, and Nameboy. Okay, now the last tip is to register your corresponding social media handles. Now this has also become very important these days, because what happens is if your website becomes popular, it will be difficult for you. If you have not already, you know, signed up with Facebook or Twitter, then it will be difficult for you to in the future to get the same username. For example, my website name is blogtoot.com. Now, if I want to create a page on Facebook, I should try to select the same name, okay? Like facebook.com/blogtoot. Okay, that will be very, very nice. twitter.com/blogdude. So you should do these things immediately, because if you don't do this, if your website becomes popular, someone will surely get your website name and they will keep their username as that name, and that name will be unavailable in the future. So that is not a good idea. Alright guys, now these were the 10 tips from my side that I think will really, really help you guys in, you know, selecting your perfect domain name. I hope this video helps you. If you found this video helpful, make sure to give a thumbs up to this video. If you have any doubt, any queries, if you want any suggestions from me, if you want to, you know, suggest me something, if you have some ideas for me, then leave them in the comment section below. And make sure to click on that red subscribe button and also click on that bell icon so that you don't miss any future videos. Alright guys, so thanks a lot for watching this video. See you soon.